Hello, Jasmine. I don't know whether you can hear me.
Hi, I can hear you.
I just wanted to check I was in the right meeting because there's no Andrea on the screen.
She was here. I don't know where she's gone.
Oh, right. Okay.
She was here playing music and now she's vanished. So, but it's not 7:30 yet, so.
That's true, yes.
Good evening. My internet just went down. As you do, right about 2 seconds before we go. How is everybody? We all good? Right. Hello, honey. All right.
Yeah, good.
Good, good. It's been quite a nice day, hasn't it?
Hasn't been bad at all, has it? Yeah. Can't complain, make the most of them.
Hello, absolutely now. Hi, Caroline. Hi, Kathleen.
Hello. Hello. You all right?
Hi, Lynn. Yes, I'm good, thank you.
I've had lots of fun.
Just getting ready for a beefer.
Hello.
The old stuff I've got here. Oh, I'm not even kidding. Getting my case.
Oh, I'm just trying to travel light and it's not working very well.
Well, normally I do travel light, so
Yeah.
yeah, having all this like cacao. I mean, I was just saying, I bet you my case gets pulled out because I've got bags of cacao in there, I've got bags of powder with all my cinnamon and spices.
Oh, God.
My case gets
Local drug dealer.
When it goes through, I know when it goes through the scanner, it'll be like, oh, hey, oh. Lovely. Right, I'm gonna move over there. I'm hoping the internet should be okay. We've just literally got a new internet up, but my old one's up. So I've been on both and I've just gone back onto my old one. So we should be all right now. The other one's not quite stable yet, so hopefully we're all good. Can you hear the music all right? Is that coming through? Is it loud or
Quiet.
can you hear it? Yeah, I'll move. I'll just put a tiny, tiny bit. Oh, sorry. Is that a bit better?
Need a little bit more.
Jasmine, really nice to see you. I was just talking to Maria the other night. Oh, lovely. I was just asking about you. Are you all right?
I'm better than I was, Andrea.
Fabulous. That is really good to know. Really good to know. I'm really happy to hear that.
Thank you.
Amazing. Oh, gorgeous. All right. So, I think I put in the group. It doesn't matter if you don't have these, but you can use these if you want. Some amethyst and some lavender oil if you've got some. And then I'm just going to go into a little meditation. And also, we are going to go into some, just a little bit of info about the moon that is coming up, which is a bit of an emotional one. I don't know if anyone else is feeling that, feeling the emotions a bit. So I'm just going to head over here. Can everyone hear me all right still? And those of you that are in your rooms at home using your tellies, it sometimes works quite well to pin me up onto your screen and then you can see, and then you don't have the gallery. So I don't know if you've got that up already. You might have. Okay, so let's land. If you've got a candle, you might have lit a few candles. I've got all my little candles going on in the background. We can just start off by lighting our candle. Might just turn this light off, see if you can still see. Okay, if I turn this bigger light off, it's a bit more cozy. So just lighting your candle. If you've got a piece of crystal, of amethyst, if you've got some, it's quite nice just to have that on your mat or at the top of your mat or the side of your mat. We're actually going to go into a yin class tonight because I think the full moon can sometimes, we've got a full moon eclipse just coming up, so it can feel a bit, it can feel a bit quirky. So I thought we'd do some nice grounding tonight. So having your oil, again, if you've got some, and we're actually moving into a full moon in Pisces, which again is a water sign. So we've got this watery full moon. And we're also heading towards the autumn equinox, which is a time of like reflection. Equinoxes are always like this balance point, but it's a time of reflection. But it's also like a time of celebration and just looking back over the year and seeing how, you know, what we've achieved, what we've created, what's changed. And kind of a reset point. I quite like to think of it as a reset point. So Pisces in body astrology is the sign of the feet and the lymphatic system. So I thought we might start off with a little foot massage. So if you want to grab your oil, and we'll just take a little moment just to take some, and it doesn't matter if you don't have lavender, we can just use anything that you've got really. So just giving your feet a nice little massage and just connecting to the feet in a way that feels nice. So eclipses can be times of transformation as well. And in the wisdom wheel, full moon is the sacred woman archetype. So it is like this lovely queenly energy who really stands in her power and is not affected so much by what other people think or say, or so she really holds her ground in this lovely energy. So just going to rub your feet, and then once you've done that, we'll get into a nice comfortable position. And then I thought we'd just start off with the Yana mudra, or the chin mudra. You might have seen it before. It's the wisdom mudra. So it's the thumb and the index finger touch, and the other three fingers are extended away, so thumb and index finger. And then we're just going to let that sit onto the knees or onto the lap. And again, just let yourself land. So just take a couple of nice deep breaths, and you might like to breathe in through your nose and release out through the mouth. Let's close down the eyes. So they just start to really gather and call back your energy from all of the places it's been today. All the people, the interactions that we've had. So with each in-breath, calling your energy in, and then with each out-breath, guiding your energy down. So we just start to come in and down. So this is the natural energy that we're following. The lavender, my gift to you is contemplation and calm communication. And the mantra is, it's okay to pause, to rest, and just be. And so as we move into this moon energy, which is coming up tomorrow, we are invited to really tap into our intuition. So as we begin to draw our energy down, grounding our energy, just take your awareness down to the very base of your spine, to the parts that are in contact with the ground here. And then you might like just to start to make like a circling movement, just small and slow. Imagine that you just begin to wind your energy down. As if you are sending a root, like a tap root or a life thread down. Down through the floor of your building. Down through the foundations of your building. Down into the softness of the earth beneath. So gathering your energy and bringing it down. Down through rock and stone. Down through layers of crystal, granite. And deeper down through sacred waters and all the way down to the heart of Mother Earth. Just feeling your energy ground, your body beginning to slow down, your nervous system beginning to quiet down. And once you feel your energy is beginning to ground a little more, again, taking a nice deep breath in. And as you breathe out, just following the breath down towards the heart cave, just to the center of your chest. This space called heart, however you want to perceive it, maybe a crystal cave, maybe a little raft on a warm, calm ocean that just floats and sustains you and feels like the most dependable thing that has ever existed. Maybe it feels like a warm hug from behind. With your energy grounded as we land into the heart space, just going to offer into the heart, beautiful heart prayer. So just taking time to settle in. Begin to drop the mind so that we just feel fully present and centered into the heart space. However you perceive that to be. And feel that each breath begins to ground you in love, in this state of love. And you can send a bit of that love down through your root and deeper down into the earth. With the next conscious breath, Imagine connecting with your soul. Maybe lean back a little bit as if your soul is giving you a hug. Intend to meet with love. So then ask whatever it is that you might be bringing into this moment, into this full moon energy. Like, what is being illuminated for you right now? What is present in your life? Maybe some answers that you'd like clarity on. So maybe offer to your heart, what does love want to share with me today? What does love want to share with me today? And with the third conscious breath, just really feel as if gratitude just begins to rise in your heart. And maybe there is just one thing that happened today that you feel like, oh, that was such a lovely thing that happened. Something that you are really grateful for right now. Maybe as you scan back through the year, what are you grateful for this past season? Summer solstice through to the autumn equinox. And as we are being gathered in a little bit now, as autumn begins to unfold, how can we nurture ourselves as we enter into this more autumnal phase of the season? Begin to gently deepen your breaths, maybe just releasing your mudra. And we'll just have a nice stretch, just taking your arms overhead. And maybe a little twist to the right. And then a twist to the left. And then just bringing yourselves back into center. You can just have the hands rested onto the knees. We're just going to start a little movement to just to gently roll the head. Again, this moon is related to the lymphatic system. And so we've got lots and lots of lymph nodes all around the body. And the only way that we get that lymph fluid moving is through contraction of muscles. So just gently rolling the head and the neck, just releasing any tension that might be hanging out there. Maybe give your jaw a little wriggle, maybe open the mouth, you can stick out the tongue, squeeze the eyes, just let your face relax, any tension today. Maybe just turning the head to look towards the right and then towards the left. Just beginning to really unwind the body. And then gentle shoulder rolls. So again, you can do both shoulders at the same time or just one at a time. But this session is a water element flow that works very well with this moon, with the full moon essence. And the moon has fullness, has this pull on the ocean, and our bodies are made up of like 70-75% of water, so the moon can also affect our bodies as well. Just gentle rolls for the shoulders and then just maybe some arm rotations, just back and forth. So we're going to just get into the lymph nodes around the armpits. As you bring the arms up to shoulder height, just gently rotating in the shoulders. You might add into that a little bit of breath breathing in as the chest lifts, and then breathing out as it lowers slightly. And we're going to bring the backs of the hands together. And as the backs of the wrists come together, just let the head drop in. And then as the arms, the hands open, the chest open and lifts, we're going to breathe in there. So we get that opening of the chest on the in-breath and then rounding on the out-breath as the backs of the hands come together in this lovely flow. It's just really connected to the breath. Just imagine your arms are like wings, breathing it in and then rounding, folding your wings in. Just starting to wake up a little bit, chest space, especially if you've been sat over computers today. And just really open, chest open for yourself. Okay, and then just letting the hands rest gently onto your knees again, just letting the shoulders relax. And then we're just going to take a gentle twist, just from side to side. Again, just in a way that feels good for your spine. Just bring in a little bit of fluidity through the spine. Okay, good. And then just come in again. Back to the center. And again, just if you need to move your body anywhere else to release, then just doing whatever you need to do. Now we're going to come into our first yin posture tonight, which is going to be caterpillar. So in caterpillar, if you want to, it is caterpillar in a like natural yoga class is like seated forward bend. So you can either have no support at all, just giving your bottom a little wriggle, pulling any flesh away from the sit bones and just gently leaning into that. So that can be like the full expression of that pose. You can also have your bolster underneath your knees, so you've got a little bit of support under the knees, and then again you can just rest in between. And I quite like this one because you just get that bit of extra support as we drop into this pose. You can also have your bolster kind of on its end, so if you wanted to have it on its end as well. Then we can also do this way, which is equally lovely. And if you're finding that your mind is a bit thinky, then this is quite a nice option as we just start to quieten in. So just find your place, the best place for you and the best the best posture really that you can relax into, because this is all about slowing down. And this forward bend, this particular posture is amazing for the nervous system and also for the immune system. Once we're in pose, just let your body find its place of comfort. And then we begin to then connect with the breath, following the out breath. And then we just let gravity begin to do the work. We let go into the posture. And your body begin to melt, let go. This is the time of full moon is very much around the time of letting go of stuff that we don't really want to carry with us. I likened this at the weekend we were in circle, and I talked about like all of our old stuff can feel like a backpack of rock rocks and boulders that we're carrying around with us all the time. So as we move into this quite powerful time with the moon and the equinox, like, what am I ready to like let go of, to take out of this backpack that is weighing me down, the stuff I might have been carrying around for a long time? Allowing, again, maybe a sense of relaxing in a little bit more. And if you do have your amethyst crystal there as well, you can also tune into the vibration of that. And the amethyst properties are peace and calmness, and they help to promote our intuition, this inner knowing and this inner wisdom. Really help us with any feelings of stress or anxiety that might happen when we're in these full moon energies, when it feels quite powerful, that energy can feel powerful. Taking your last three breaths there, and before we come out of this pose nice and slowly, just offer an affirmation. I trust my inner wisdom and intuition flowing effortlessly with the energy of this moon. I trust my inner wisdom and intuition flowing effortlessly with the energy of this moon. So we're going to come out nice and slow. Again, give yourself a little bit of support if you need to. And then you might just want to come up to like a cross-legged position, or just once you get to the upright position. And I'm going to just work with, again, a gentle twist to rebound this pose. So just going to twist around to the left. And then gently to the right. So just gentle twisting just to rebound the pose. And then one more each side. So again, we want to be nourishing through this yin practice, because it's going to build our energy well, even though it's slow. Yeah, lovely. So going back to center, we're going to come into our butterfly pose next. And you might like, again, to use support under your knees. So for the butterfly, well, the feet are going to come together. If you do have hips that are painful, or you just want to do less, then just having that little bit of support can be really beautiful. It's a bit more restorative in that way. Or if you know, if your hips are good, they're open, and again, it feels quite nice to do it in this way, then having the knees wide, you can hang on to your toes a little bit, and then again, just lean in. So the head drops forwards again. And we just find our way into this lovely butterfly pose. So from caterpillar to butterfly, as a metaphor, we have this, you know, I always think with these two poses together, this essence of like the women that we are yet to become. And that we are always in these states of metamorphosis where we are becoming more. So as we come into the butterfly, we remember also that sometimes we do have to go through a little bit of mush as we metamorphose into the next versions of ourselves as we transition. Again, just giving ourselves the space and the time to relax and restore. especially around the full moon time, is so important for us. Let's just begin to contemplate the essence of water element. Maybe even bring to mind a body of water that you love to be around, maybe the ocean, maybe a waterfall. And the water really connects us to the divine feminine, to the feminine. And the water is a sacred fluid that nourishes the earth and sustains all life. And it is a mirror of the goddess, these beautiful goddess energies that are deep and mysterious, but beautifully nurturing for us. As you follow the breath, maybe feeling into the breath like the ocean waves in and out of the body. And again, just in the presence of water, we find a place of sanctuary for reflection and renewal. Teach us to let go of what is no longer serving us, to surrender to the currents of life within. Just have a check into your body. And just checking in with where you're at, if you want to go maybe a little deeper. Right, want to back a little bit in there just for the last breath. Taking the last three breaths there. Yeah, I'm just going to come out really slow. So just very, very gently walking your way back. You might want to give your knees a little bit of support there as you bring the knees back to centre. I'm just going to come into a little windshield wiper. So just taking the feet wide. Leaning back onto your hands. And I'm just going to swish the knees side to side. A little bit of hips can feel a little bit broken when we come out of these poses. Just allowing the hips to release. Then from here we're going to come down onto our back. So just going to come into a little cradle to begin with. So as you come down, I'm going to bring the knees in towards the chest. And just hold the knees in, and then I'm just going to gently rock side to side. Again, just massaging that lower back area around where the kidneys and the adrenal glands are. These are the areas that get a lot of hammer if we're getting a bit stressed. Just giving those little areas some love here. And again, if we were to be guided by the wisdom of our heart, and, you know, that question, like, what would love have me know today? So if we were to apply love to our body, yeah, just nice and gently, we wouldn't push and force ourselves. We would be kind. Just nice movement. Okay, good. Now I'm going to bring the feet together. Just bring a hand on each knee. I'm just going to do some nice circles for the hips. So just taking the knees, we're going to come away from the center line and out to the sides. Big toes kind of stay together. But just circling out. So again, the watery full moon can feel a little emotional, and we do can hold a lot of emotional energy stuck around the hips. So just loosening there without overdoing it, but just letting the hips get a little bit of love here. Beautiful. So we're going to bring the knees across to one side. Now, again, if you've got any spine issues at all, you might want to take the feet to the floor first and then let the knees drop over to one side. If you've got no problems at all with the spine, then you can go from knees in towards the chest and just let the knees gently rock across to one side. The arms can be wide. And then you're going to look to the opposite direction of your knees. So again, finding that place that works best for you and allowing gravity to do the work. And again, as you just follow your breath, feeling the belly, nice massage across the belly as you breathe, any tension around the rib cage. Got lots of lymph nodes around the rib cage, around the diaphragm. Getting that lovely massage with the breath. Letting everything relax in this pose, in this lying pose. And if we just bring our awareness to the heart space, the center of the chest, just feel that that is your center. And then we have this awareness of the body being in opposite directions. So we've got one heading in one direction, the other in the other. We find that place of center, again, at this turning point in the year, of the past energy, the energy of the last season to one side, but the energy also that is yet to come as we face in that direction. But we find our center of presence right within that. The breath will always guide us into this moment. This moment is the only moment that we ever have. So we pull the breath into the heart cave, that beautiful space in the heart. And just really nourishing the body with breath. Breath might move a little deeper into the rib cage. So we start to send the breath into the space that we've created for it. Feeling the body's heaviness. Some connection with the earth. The Yeah, with each breath, just gathering your energy, drawing it in, calling it back. Yeah, just taking the last three breaths there. And I'm going to just very, very slowly release back to cradle. Again, just hugging the knees in towards the chest. And just taking a gentle rock side to side. Might even like to go in circles, just really starting to follow an intuitive flow with your body. Your body is kind of telling you where it needs to release, to clear. I'm going to go across the other side. So again, if you want to have the feet on the floor or the knees in towards the chest for this, then, you know, just working with what works best for your body. I'm going to take that across to the opposite side. Again, once you found that perfect place for you, just close down the eyes, observe, and just feel into the spaces that might feel a little tight, and breathe into those spaces. Hope you just begin to release tension or tightness, especially around the hips, lower back, or the kidney area. And the breath just becomes that calming anchor. Allows us to anchor into the moment, gathering our energy inward, day past. Taking your last three breaths there. Again, I'm going to come back into the cradle. So just slowly releasing these poses. And coming back to a gentle rocking. Good. Our last pose tonight is going to be Sphinx pose. So I'm going to come onto your belly because this is one of the best poses for water element to build our water flow, to nourish our kidneys. And I think the full moon energies are very good to kind of do this work here. So you can have your feet as wide or as close as feels good. I'm going to bring the elbows underneath the shoulders. The hands are extended, middle finger kind of points forwards. So if you think about the Sphinx, Egyptian Sphinx, you're sort of kind of lifting out of the like the lower spine. And then you can just let the head drop forwards if that feels good. I actually quite like to cross my ankles and bend my knees as well. It just gives a little more activation around the lower back. So again, just closing your eyes. And then once you've found that place that works for you, just beginning to be aware of your breath and where it's going. So just feel it into maybe the belly. And again, you might just feel that connection with the belly and the ground, massaging the womb space and also the digestive system. But also you might feel an activation around the lower back too. You might even imagine that area bathed with a lovely blue energy, like mist colour. But this sense of replenishing the kidneys, the adrenals. Again, if you've had periods where you've been a bit stressed, just allowing your body to rebalance itself, which it is perfectly capable to do. Slowing the breath down. Again, just creating those circumstances for the body to balance, find its state of equilibrium. Again, the equinox and solstice energies are all about balance, bringing that balance as we head into the slightly darker nights. And you might even feel a gentle pull to cozy in a little bit. And then just taking your last three breaths there. I'm just going to relax down into like a crocodile. So if you bring the elbows out to the sides, make a pillow with your hands and just let your head rest, your forehead rest. Your heels drop out to the sides. And again, just letting your body come to a state of rest. Going to come from here into child's pose. So just gently, in a way again that suits your body, that feels good, finding your way back into a child's pose, whether you have the knees wide, arms extended or by sides, forehead maybe to the earth. And again, as you rest here, just bringing that third eye center, the Ashley center, to the earth, and just really connecting into that inner wisdom that is within, that inner guide, and that affirmation, I trust my inner wisdom and intuition, flowing effortlessly with the energy of the full moon. I trust my inner wisdom and intuition flowing effortlessly, the energy of the full moon. Now I'm going to just very, very gently and slowly unfold from our child's pose and come to rest into a lovely shavasana. So just bring in your blankets, jumpers, whatever you need, like eye pillows if you've got them. And just find in a place of stillness now. Letting your body rest. So just taking a few breaths there. Feeling the different parts of your body that are in contact with the ground beneath. I'm just going to come into a gentle ocean relaxation. For those of you that love water, enjoy this. Again, just being aware that if you have had any experiences around water that don't feel so good, this is going to be a watery process. So just being aware of that. As you bring yourself to a place of stillness and just softly close the eyes, your body sink and soften a little more into the ground beneath. Following the flow of the breath in and out of the body. Maybe imagine your breath, your movement of your breath like the ocean waves. The breath moves in, fullness of the wave, and the breath moves out as it releases back to itself. Just gently allowing your breath calm and relax your body. As you begin to imagine yourself standing on the edge of a vast ocean, sky is clear, water stretches endlessly before you. The air is cool and fresh and filled with the scent of the sea. Feel a soft sand beneath your feet and the gentle breeze on your skin. And as you breathe in, you notice the saltiness in the air. And with each breath, you feel more connected to the ocean, its rhythms and its soothing presence. Imagine gently walking towards the water and stepping into the shallow waves. The water is warm and inviting, lapping at your feet. Your feet sink a little into the sand. You feel a gentle pull with each wave. Completely safe and connected to the flow of water. You focus on the rhythmic waves. Notice how they mirror the natural flow of your breath. Each in-breath draws in peace, calm. And each out-breath releases tension and anything you are ready to let go of. Now imagine yourself floating in the ocean. Water cradles you, supporting your body completely. Feel weightless, deeply relaxed, fully supported by the ocean. Imagine gentle waves rocking you like a lullaby from the sea. The ocean represents your emotions, flowing freely without resistance. Trust that the ocean, like your emotion, knows how to move and guide you. With each gentle wave, feel your body and mind releasing any remaining stress, tension or worries. The water carrying away anything that no longer serves you. Just allowing yourself to rest in the ocean's waves, gentle holding energy, completely supported. As you hear the rhythm of the waves, just let the wisdom of the ocean speak to you. The ocean holds ancient knowledge, deep mysteries. Allow it to fill your spirit with peace. The understanding that life, like the waves, constant flow of highs and lows. As you rest in this awareness, know that you are always supported. You can ride the waves of life with grace and peace. Gradually into visualize yourself coming back to the shore, feeling the sand beneath your feet again, and the water receding. As you gently deepen your breath, maybe stretching in a way that feels good. Gently rolling off onto one side. Slowly bringing yourselves gently back. Time. And slowly coming back to sit. Just maybe bringing the palms together and rubbing the palms to create a little bit of heat in your hands. And gently cupping the palms of your eyes, just letting your eyes rest into the warmth of your hands. And then using your fingertips to gently massage over your head, into your face, your neck, your shoulders, so anywhere that just feels good. Bringing our hands into prayer position at our heart. Just taking a moment again, just with our eyes closed, just to hold the energy that we've cultivated here in this practice with this beautiful moon that is arriving shortly. The element of water, the sacred feminine. Let's celebrate this sacred presence by embracing our own divine nature, by nurturing ourselves and others with love, and by walking our paths with grace and purpose. As we honour the sacred feminine, we honour the very essence of life itself, and we become vessels of her infinite wisdom and love. Allowing a beautiful inner smile rise from your heart, your face, and to your eyes. And as you open your eyes, into a beautiful night's sleep, hopefully. Namaste, everybody. You all alright? Get straight in bed now. Gorgeous. Is everyone all right? Everybody back in the room? Well, just a little reminder, we've got a goddess circle on Wednesday night online with goddess Lalita, who is like a really sensual goddess. So it's 7:30 till 9 on this link again. It's the same link, I'll put it in the group. We'll be doing a little bit of journaling, some movement and journey. So if you would love to join, it is free and you're all welcome to come along, and it'll be lovely to journey with this goddess who I have not journeyed with before. So I'm quite excited to meet her as well. So have a lovely rest of your week. Hopefully I'll see you on Wednesday. Big love, everyone. See you soon.
Thank you. Thanks.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.